This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Sir Robert McAlpine is a private British company headquartered in Hertfordshire. It carries out engineering and construction for the oil and gas, petrochemical, power generation, nuclear, pharmaceutical, defence, chemical, water and mining industries. Contents 1 History 11 The Irish Connection 2 Structure 3 Major Projects 4 Controversies 5 References 6 Sources History Sir Robert McAlpine, 1st Baronet who founded the eponymous company, was born in 1847 in the Scottish village of Newarthill near Motherwell. From the age of 7 he worked in the nearby coal mines, leaving at 16 to become an apprentice bricklayer. Later, working for an engineer, he progressed to being foreman before starting to work on his own account at the age of 22. 1869 he had no capital other than that he could earn himself, and his first contract involving the employment of other men had to be financed by borrowing £11 from the butcher from there. McAlpine enjoyed rapid success. The early contracts centered on his own trade of bricklaying, and by 1874 he was the owner of 2 brickyards and an employer of 1,000 men. It was on one of the housing estates he built that he first experimented with using concrete blocks as well as bricks, from which he earned the nickname Concrete Bob. The Glenfinnan Viaduct. With the capital he had acquired, McAlpine determined to build a garden city at Hamilton, South Lanarkshire, relying now on the income from his estate. McAlpine's attention moved away from his contracting business towards self-education. However, the financial panic following the collapse of the City of Glasgow Bank in 1878 virtually wiped out McAlpine financially. His mortgages were called in, but his debtors did not pay him. The liabilities from the Hamilton estate were threatening the construction business, and to protect it, Robert took his clerk into partnership, trading under the name McAlpine. Him, with Malcolm and Alfred following soon after, and they did much to rationalize the firm's administration and finances. Undaunted by his earlier experience, McAlpine took on further railway contracts, this time successfully, including the Mallaig Extension Railway and the Glasgow Subway. There was an increasingly wide range of building and civil engineering contracts, but the firm was almost brought to its knees again with the construction of the Methil Docks between 1909 and 1913. It was argued that this led to a much more cautious approach to risk on the part of the sons, if not the father. The inter-war period saw the firm focusing solely on construction. Gray wrote that Sir Robert McAlpine seemed to have been involved in every major building and civil engineering project that ever hit the headlines of the day. They included docks, harbours, power stations, factories. The Wembley Stadium and the Dorchester Hotel were notable examples. The Dorchester was of particular interest. When the client was unable to pay for the construction works, the company took possession of the completed building and operated it on its own account. Newcastle Civic Centre in November 1934, Sir Robert died aged 87 2 weeks later. The eldest son, the new Sir Robert, also died. William was appointed chairman while Alfred remained in charge of the operation in the Northwest subsidiary, where he had been since 1918. These 2 deaths must have had some impact on what followed. The 2 London partners argued that the recession was impacting more on the north than the south and proposed closing Alfred's company. Alfred, however, did not wish to return to London, and, on an informal basis at first, the 2 businesses were run separately. The separation was formalized in 1940 and the northern business was renamed Sir Alfred McAlpine. During the Second World War, the company was one of the contractors engaged in building the Mulberry Harbour units. The 2 McAlpine firms had non-compete arrangements and sites had a common McAlpine board, irrespective of which firm it was. When both companies first went public, they did so under the names Newarthill for Robert and Marchwheel for Alfred. These arrangements continued until 1983. In 2003, Sir Robert McAlpine Limited sued Alfred McAlpine PLC over the use of the family name and won. The dispute centered on Alfred McAlpine's intention to trade under the name McAlpine. There was previously a long-standing agreement within the McAlpine family not to make such a change, but, following the death of Alfred McAlpine, the board of Alfred McAlpine sought to make the change. In any event, the effect of the judgment was to prevent Alfred McAlpine trading under the name McAlpine. In 2008, Alfred McAlpine PLC was acquired by Carillion and dismantled, thus making the name war irrelevant. The Irish Connection. From the 1930s onwards, the company employed large numbers of Irish who had come to England looking for work. The harsh working conditions with which McAlpine's management treated their Labourers has gone down in Irish emigrant folklore. The song McAlpine's Fusiliers, written by Dominic Behan and made famous by the Dubliners, described the realities of life on the building site for many Irish expatriates. Structure: the company is organised on a regional basis. It has offices in Hemel Hempstead, London, Birmingham, Cardiff, Bristol, Manchester, Newcastle, Leeds, Edinburgh and Glasgow. The plant section is based in Kettering. Major projects: Emirates Stadium. Projects undertaken by the company have included Glenfinnan Viaduct completed in 1901, Main Road Stadium completed in 1923, Wembley Stadium completed in 1924, Dorchester Hotel in London completed in 1931, Odeon Leicester Square completed in 1937, the Shell Centre completed in 1962, Newcastle Civic Centre completed in 1968, Hyde Park Barracks, London completed in 1970. Royal National Theatre completed in 1977, St Enoch Centre completed in 1989, Millennium Dome completed in 1999, which the company also redeveloped as the O2 Millennium Bridge completed in 2000, Excel Exhibition Centre completed in 2000, Eden Project completed in 2001, Wishaw General Hospital completed in 2001, Imperial War Museum North completed in 2002, Bull Ring, Birmingham completed in 2003, Emirates Stadium completed in 2006, White River Place development in St Austell Town Centre completed in 2009, Olympic Stadium for London 2012 completed in 2011, 1 Kensington Gardens completed in 2015. Controversies: Sir Robert McAlpine funded the initial establishment of the Consulting Association in 1993, providing £20,000, around half of which was used to buy a blacklist database from the Economic League and hire one of its former employees, Ian Kerr, as manager. Company director Callum McAlpine served as chairman of the Consulting Association for some years before it became publicly implicated in a construction industry blacklisting scandal in 2009 and was wound up subsequently. Sir Robert McAlpine was one of eight businesses involved in the 2014 launch of the Construction Workers' Compensation Scheme, though this was condemned as a PR stunt by the GMB Union, and described by the Scottish Affairs Select Committee as an act of bad faith. On the 11th of May 2016, major companies, including Sir Robert McAlpine, issued an unreserved and sincere apology in the High Court to hundreds of workers for putting them on the illegal blacklist and denying them work over two decades. The companies agreed to pay sums ranging from £25,000 to £200,000 to 771 people under out-of-court settlements to avoid a trial, while accepting that their secret vetting operation should never have happened. However, evidence disclosed before the settlement led many of the victims to claim that there was an illegal attempt by McAlpine executives to destroy evidence and cover up the involvement of key individuals. When the blacklisting was discovered in 2009, the targets of the victims' intended criminal complaint included director Cullum McAlpine, and head of human resources, David Cochrane, who was a later chairman of the association. Both denied involvement in destroying any relevant files and attempting to pervert the course of justice. References: A.B. Sir Robert McAlpine suffers £90 million loss. Construction Inquirer, 15 May 2015, retrieved 18 May 2015. To Step Down, Contract Journal retrieved 11 July 2007. From the original PDF on 29 May 2008, retrieved 11 July 2008. Carrot, Scottish Affairs, 7th Report Blacklisting in Employment, Final Report, WWW Parliamentux Scottish Affairs Committee retrieved 7 September 2015. Arcadis Architecture Firms Arup Atkins Faithful Gould Borough Hapold Capita CH2M Kundal Davis Langdon Elliott Wood Expedition Engineering Flint. Mott MacDonald Mushal RPS Scott Wilson Suite Group WSP Housebuilders Current Barrett Bellway Berkeley Bloor Boot Bovis Countryside Properties Crest Nicholson Keepmoat Lend Lease McCarthy. William Leach Wilson Bowden Integrated Construction Balfour Beatty Bam Nuttall Carillion Cleveland Bridge Morgan Sindel Shepherd Sir Robert McAlpine Volker Fitzpatrick Waits Wilmot Dixon Suppliers Current Aggregate Industries Artex Ashteed Brogan Cemex UK Hanson London Brick HSS Hire Juicen Kingspan Kingspan Offsite Marrow Schmidlin Pilkington RMD Quickform SIG Speedy Hire Tarmac Tarmac Building Products Tata Steel Europe Travis Perkins Wolseley Defunct Blue Circle Industries Redland RMC Group Tarmac Group Government and Regulatory Bodies Department for Communities and Local Government Department for Business, Innovation and Skills Health. Federation of Master Builders HBF Institution of Civil Engineers Institution of Structural Engineers National Access and Scaffolding Confederation National Federation of Builders National Federation of Demolition Contractors National House Building Council Refined Bitumen Association Royal Institution of Chartered Surveyors Scottish Building Federation Select Electrical Contractors Association of Scotland Society of Construction Arbitrators Specialist Engineering Contractors Group Strategic Forum for Construction Sustainability Association for Environment Conscious Building BREEAM. Code for Sustainable Homes EcoHomes Energy Efficiency in British Housing Good Homes Alliance UK Green Building Council Other British Construction Industry Awards Building Building Regulations in the United Kingdom Building Regulations Approval Construction News Development Control in the United Kingdom New Civil Engineer Planning Permission Town and Country Planning in the United Kingdom Category